Hello, friends. Welcome to Colonial Park, United Church of Christ, where no matter who you are or where you are on life's journey, you are welcome here. Thank you so much for joining us in worship today, and a special thank you to those who make this worship possible, because I certainly don't do it alone. So on behalf of myself, Pastor Cindy Garris, Kathy and Bruce Neely, who help with audio and video, to Pastor Scott and to Anthony Halbert for their leading in music, and today a special thank you to Cindy Neck for coming in and being our lay reader this week. Friends, just a few announcements, most of which are in your bulletin, but some things to be aware of. First of all, we are starting to premiere our worship service on Sundays at 9:30 for the summer. So just so you are mindful of that, if you happen to be catching this a little bit later, you're catching the full recording and not necessarily joining it at the same time as others. But that being said, it also means that our fellowship time, which we have been doing via Zoom, will be at 11 o'clock. So please feel free to join us for that on Sundays at 11. Also, for the summer months, Charging Station, which is meeting on Sundays at 4 o'clock via Zoom, will continue, but it will be meeting every other week. So we met this past Sunday. We will not meet on today on the 7th, but we will then meet again on the 14th and so on throughout the summer. Also, just so you know, we know that Dauphin County is in the yellow zone right now, yellow phase, and so we want to make sure that you know that our leadership is aware of that. And on June 15th is our next council meeting, and we will be having additional conversation about what that means for our church, for gatherings at the church, and for opportunities for us to connect with one another. So be on the lookout for some additional news after council on June 15th. Finally, it's been a week of a lot. Everything from dealing with a pandemic to seeing a space shuttle or a rocket launch here in the United States, first time in over a decade, to loss of life, protests, violence, a lot of sadness. And we as a church are a people of hope. We as a church are a people of justice. Friends, I also wanted to share with you a letter that we received from the Penn Central Conference, from the staff there. You may already have read it online. We did share it in an email. But it's important to speak it. It was a letter for Pentecost, so it was from last week. But hear these words, and may we take them to heart. Pentecost is a day of testimony, not only testimony, but unity. The experience of the disciples in receiving the Holy Spirit, the preaching of Peter to those gathered, and the conversions and baptisms that followed point to the power and freedom of God. When that power and freedom move through us, we are unbound and we speak, act, and live in testimony to God's power through Jesus. We come together and we know a holy unity. Some days testimony comes easily. We rise and speak to the holiness of our diversity as made in God's image. On other days, the Spirit seems absent and we are left with only our stark humanness. Days when we see the very worst that we can be, and we grieve. This past week has held some of the most difficult days. In recent days, we were given the statistic of 100,000 deaths due to COVID. Week also gave us the death of a single man, George Floyd, that revealed again the sin of racism in America, The former resulted in grief for thousands of people. The latter resulted in grief, outrage, protests, and violence also for thousands of people. Some days the flames of Pentecost seem to be extinguished. Physical flames erupt instead, ignited from despair, anger, and desperation. The wind we hear is not the wind of the Spirit bringing us unity, repentance, and testimony. Instead of the breath of God falling on believers, we hear the labored breathing of those with COVID and those who suffocate under the force and power of others. Brothers and sisters in Christ, each of us as your conference staff has struggled with the events of this past week through prayer, tears, anger, and more prayer. We look within ourselves and know that our own lives have not been the witness to God's kingdom that they should be. As we say in one prayer of confession, we recognize all the things we have done and those things we have left undone. As the staff of the Penn Central Conference, we commit ourselves again to the practice of witnessing to the image of God in every person through how we speak and how we act, embracing the great commandment to love our neighbor as ourselves, knowing that our witness is fueled by flames of holy love for all humankind, and the knowledge that there is no longer Jew or Greek, slave or free, no longer male or female, for all of you are one in Christ Jesus, as Galatians says. We pray that you, our communities of faith, will join us in continuing to advocate for the powerless, examining carefully your own privilege and bearing witness to the holy wind that unites and empowers. May each of us be a single flame that brings light, burns away falsehood, and ignites healing for individuals, our church, and our nation. It's signed by Reverend Dr. Carrie Call, Reverend Nora Faust, Reverend Dr. Marissa Laviola, Reverend Dr. Ronette Comfort Butler, Ms. Zoe Dedeen, Mr. Paul Keller, and I would add my name to that. May we all live into this. Again, thank you for being here. May we be united as we worship one God in spirit and in truth. Let us prepare our hearts and minds for worship.
Thank you.
Let us join in our call to worship. Sometimes life takes us where we don't expect.
Sometimes God takes us where we don't expect.
In worship, we gather to get in touch with God's bigger narrative.
In worship, we gather to expand our hearts.
So let us worship the God of unending surprises.
Let us worship the God of love. God, we come before you today with weary hearts and wandering souls. Bring us back to the present moment. Gather us together as your people. Reaffirm our place in your kingdom community. This we pray with thanksgiving for your guiding presence. Amen.
My friends, we are a people prone to wander, as the song says. How quickly we turn away from God's face when we are lost or afraid. So let us turn back now. Let us return to God in this moment and face our loving Creator. Creator God, being faithful has never been easy. You asked Noah to build a ship when there wasn't a drop of rain. You asked the Israelites to plant gardens and build homes while in exile. You asked the prophets to speak challenging truths. You asked the disciples to drop their nets and follow you. You ask us to love bigger than society wants to. You ask us to love our enemies. Being faithful has never been easy. And as a result, we often miss the mark. So forgive us. Forgive us for holding tightly to human-made plans. Forgive us for the times we say no to you so that we can say yes to ourselves. Unravel the grip we have on our agendas so that we can make room for you. Gratefully we pray. Amen. The prayer I've chosen to include here is a video clip from a commentary and reflection from our general and minister, Reverend John C. Dorhauer.
So let me pray. God, whose breath animates us all, we pray for all whose breath has been taken from them by force. God, whose hand created us all in your image, end, please, the senseless and shameful devotion to white skin privilege and preference. God, whose son bore the scars of an empire threatened by a love that welcomed all, help us to endure our own scars when empire clashes with our offerings of love and peace. And God, whose son came to topple the mighty from their thrones and scatter the proud in the imagination of their hearts, may the toppling and scattering needed for your shalom to be fully realized endure where power corrupts and pride decays. Amen.
My friends, hear these words. Life is often unpredictable, but the grace of God is unwavering. It never changes. It goes before us, behind us, beside us. Know that you are already forgiven and that you will be sustained by grace. Thanks be to God.
Almighty Jesus Christ, Redeemer of this life, hallelujah, you are Savior, beginning and the end, forgiver of my sin, by your mercy you have saved us. Jesus, you are stronger, more than any other. Hallelujah, what a Savior. Jesus, you are higher, my soul's deepest desire. Hallelujah, you are Savior. You are the Shepherd King, you lead us by still waters. Hallelujah, you are Savior. You are my only hope, your kindness is my friend, and in your presence you restore us. Jesus, you are stronger, more than any other.
Please join me in prayer. God of unending surprises, this life is a tapestry of moments woven together, and we long to be weavers of love. Together we gather and pray that you would unravel our bias, unravel our assumptions, unravel whatever it is that keeps us from you. And as you do, clear space in our hearts for your word. We are listening. We are praying. Amen. The scripture lesson today comes from the book of the Hebrew prophet Jeremiah, chapter 29, verses 1 through 14. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people. These are the words of the letter that the prophet Jeremiah sent from Jerusalem to the remaining elders among the exiles, and to the priests, the prophets, and all the people whom Nebuchadnezzar had taken into exile from Jerusalem to Babylon. This was after King Jeconiah and the queen mother, the court officials, the leaders of Judah and Jerusalem, the artisans and the smiths had departed from Jerusalem. The letter was sent by the hand of Elisha, son of Shaphan, and Gemariah, son of Hilkiah, whom King Zedekiah of Judah sent to Babylon to King Nebuchadnezzar of Babylon. It said, "Thus says the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, to all the exiles whom I have sent into exile from Jerusalem to Babylon. Build houses and live in them. Plant gardens and eat what they produce. Take wives and have sons and daughters. Take wives for your sons and give your daughters in marriage, that they may bear sons and daughters. Multiply there and do not decrease. But seek the welfare of the city where I have sent you into exile, and pray to the Lord on its behalf. For in its welfare, you will find your welfare. For thus says the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, do not let the prophets and the diviners who are among you deceive you, and do not listen to the dreams that they dream, for it is a lie that they are prophesying to you in my name. I did not send them, says the Lord. For thus says the Lord, only when Babylon's 70 years are completed will I visit you, and I will fulfill to you my promise and bring you back to this place. For surely I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord, plans for your welfare and not for harm, to give you a future with hope. Then when you call upon me and come and pray to me, I will hear you. When you search for me, you will find me. If you seek me with all your heart, I will let you find me, says the Lord, and I will restore your fortunes and gather you from all the nations and all the places where I have driven you, says the Lord, and I will bring you back to the place from which I sent you into exile.
Let us pray.
By the waters of Babylon, where we sat down, and where we lived, when we remember Zion, by the waters of Babylon, where we sat down.
Indeed, may the words of my mouth, the meditations of our hearts, the spirit in this place be pleasing and acceptable to you, O God, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. We are in our series, our unraveled series, and life is unraveling. Life has been, in many respects, unraveling for us for at least the past couple of months. We certainly know that feeling. And today we get to talk a little bit about when our dreams unravel. I'm sure there are many of you who can identify with that. Life didn't quite turn out how you planned. Or if you could imagine something, it was not this. That is probably true for every person listening to this. In some respects, because we have huge dreams, and in other respects, because we dream so tiny. I, for one, never, ever imagined that I would be a parish pastor, but even if I remotely did, I certainly never thought I would be at Colonial Park United Church of Christ. We can't imagine what life really is about. And that's a bit where the people that Jeremiah is writing a letter to, where they are in life. Now, they are actually in exile. You see, Life in the Middle East has always been fraught with land being overtaken and powers being overthrown. For some of us, that might be in our households. But at this particular time, we're told that the Jewish people are, the children of Israel are in exile, the Babylonian exile. They have been cast out from their home, their faith in some respects, their religious community, their society in Jerusalem. And part of what they are asking is exactly what Psalm 137 says. How can we sing a holy song in a strange land? How can we live? What do we do now? 2,000 years later, more than that, 3,000 years later, the questions are the same. We want to go back, is what they're saying to Jeremiah. We want to go back. How do we go back to Jerusalem? Get us back there. And isn't that what we hear in our churches today? We want to go back. Now, it is not that I don't want to see you all again. It is not that I don't think we should all come together in worship once again. But perhaps God is doing a new thing. In fact, in Jeremiah's case, when they are there and crying out to Jeremiah that they want to go back, he actually does not give them a prophetic word of deliverance. He doesn't tell them, God will deliver you. What does he tell them? The word of the Lord is this: plant crops, build houses, have children, get married, see your grandchildren. I mean, this is a long-term deal. What an unexpected answer. And then he says something along these lines, that God had told him that God would be with them there in that place of exile, and that God hasn't given up on them. That God, if they turn toward God, if they pray, if they remain faithful, God will be not lost to them. God will be found. Again, another unexpected kind of response, because didn't God only reside in Jerusalem? Doesn't God only show up in the sanctuary of a church? Not according to many of us, as you already know, and certainly not according to the word of Jeremiah. Remaining faithful to God in these times of this paradigm shift is monumental and is the invitation. When life unravels, what do we do? When dreams unravel, what do? We let them unravel. I read a devotional this week where the author was saying, everything is breaking. My heart is breaking, our systems are breaking, everything is breaking. And then she says, and let them break. Maybe they needed to. To a certain extent, in our Unraveled series, we are invited not to make everything all better. Let it unravel. Because maybe it is being unraveled for something new. We ask the question, what do we do? What do we do now, like the children of Israel, in this foreign place? And it's hard for us to hear sing. It's hard for us to hear pray. It's hard for us to hear live life. it's even harder for us to hear and make your community better, even for your enemies. That thing that Jesus then promotes of love your enemies. Whew, this faith thing is not easy. And life continues to unravel. I've had to think a little bit about the questions that I and many of us have now are questions that actually many, especially many people of color, many immigrants, have had for a very long time. Our brothers and sisters have been asking for the longest time, wait, isn't this America where we have the American dream? Wait, isn't this a land of opportunity? Isn't this home of the brave? Isn't this a place for life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness for everyone? Wait, aren't we all created equal? As people of faith, but not only as people of faith, we look at these questions and know them, right? We know the what we do now because this isn't how it was expected to be. So how do we make it that way? How do we make it a land, a community, a place, a home that it is supposed to be? Justice, full of mercy and kindness, love. I also had to think this week when I was thinking about those who dream, I had to think of Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King in 1963. And his famous, I have a dream speech at the Lincoln Memorial. And I thought, oh man, we have not really come that far, have we? And then I watched the news. Now granted, that can be pretty depressing. And then I saw all of these faces of young people and old people and people of color not like mine in solidarity with one another saying, enough. And isn't that actually what Jeremiah was saying? Is don't get so concerned about going back to someplace. Be concerned about the life that you are making right here, right now, and the life that you are making for your children and your children's children, and what are they going to grow up in? We have dreams. And sometimes our dreams need to unravel, and we need to be surprised by God again and again and again so that we sit again in that crazy place between a dream that has been dashed and a dream of what could be. What are we willing to let go of and stop clinging to, and what do we need to hold fast to lean into the future together? We too are in a paradigm shift. Christendom is not going to be the way of the future. I don't know what Christianity will look like in the future, but I know I'm part of making it. So are you. What is the church known for? How do people see God? How do people experience holiness, sacredness, and love? They experience it because of how we live, what we are willing to make and co-create in this community. What do we do in this time when it doesn't look like anything we've known before? It's a bit of a reason I put this prayer shawl out here today. As a reminder, Natalie dropped this off. Natalie Lubold, thank you very much, dropped this off at my office. Said, I have another prayer shawl for you. This one, she said, is the odds and ends I had around the house. What do we do with the stuff that's unraveled and left in our homes, in our churches, in our lives? We make something new and we pray. We pray. We dream a new dream. The other word that came to me this week was actually in the movie La La Land. And it was the audition piece that the Emma Stone character has. She's a wannabe or a person striving to make it big. And she's reflecting on the story of her aunt, and she moves into singing this song. And I'm going to share a clip of that with you now.
Foolish as they may seem, here's to the hearts that ache, here's to the mess we make. She captured a feeling, sky with no ceiling, sunset inside a frame. She lived in her liquor and died with a flicker. I'll always remember the flame. Here's to the ones who dream, foolish as they may seem. Here's to the hearts that ache. Here's to the mess we make. She told me a bit of madness is key to give us new colors to see. Who knows where it will lead us?
Love that piece. I love in particular, so bring on the rebels, the ripples from pebbles, the painters and poets and plays, and here's to the fools who dream. Crazy as they may seem, here's to the hearts that break. Because they need breaking. Here's to the mess we make, and I would say the mess that God is making. I can't take all the credit for the mess. God is doing a new thing. And when our dreams unravel, we turn to God and pray. We listen. We work to make better communities. We work to live as another prophet said, "What does the Lord require of you? Do justice, love kindness, and walk humbly with God." May it be so. Amen. Friends, as we come to our time of prayers of the people, once again, I invite you to respond where you are as the people parts. I also invite you to share your prayer requests with us. Our prayer chain has been continually praying during this time as we've received many of your requests, either through our online prayer request form or with a phone call or an email or a text. We want to be with you in this time, so please let us know how we can pray. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, who looks with loving compassion on all of your creation, we lift up our prayers to you. There are so many who have been displaced by flood and fire, war and famine. May they be fed and cared for, and may they find kindness on their journeys. Lead them to a safe place to find comfort under the shelter of your wings. May they find their home in you.
For those who have found themselves where they did not expect to be, O Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have experienced loss of homes, jobs, good health, and of loved ones, may they find your love and the light of your promises to be enough for the next step. Lead them to a place of hope, to find glimpses of joy in their journey. Bind up their wounds so tenderly, and fill them again with your goodness and mercy.
For those who grieve and seek a path forward toward hope, O Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have wandered far from you, who feel forsaken, forgotten, or fearful, may they find that you are not so far off after all. May they trust in your prodigal love and run into your outstretched arms with joy.
For those who are lost and in need of God's welcome, O Lord, hear our prayer.
And lastly, we pray for those of us who are comfortable, safe, healthy, and secure. We heartily thank you for your many blessings. May we be agents of your blessing to others as we seek the peace and prosperity of this city. Lead us to those whom you look upon with compassion, the overworked, the underfed, the neglected, and the depressed. Fill us with your grace and mercy and love, that we may be healers in your name.
For those in need of what we have to offer, O Lord, hear our prayer.
Hear us now as we pray, as Jesus taught the disciples to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Thank you.
Good morning. If you remember last week's service, Pastor Cindy made note of her long hair. I don't think her hair was really that long. Case in point, this is long hair. My hair is long. and it hasn't been cut since February. This isn't Comedy Sunday, but we know God has a sense of humor which keeps people week after week conscious of how we look when in church. I think my hair looks fine for not being physically at church, though it is getting long. But you know what? I decided not to have a haircut until we're all back at church in person. Kathy hopes it's sooner than later. My real message for today, though, is about Huffman Homes for Youth in Littlestown. Huffman is a residential treatment facility committed to personal growth and achievement for children and their families needing emotional and/or psychiatric treatment and support. Mary Jones and I are honored to represent this church as members of Huffman's board of directors. Huffman is fortunate to have over 200 part-time and full-time staff members consisting of psychiatrists, doctors, nurses, mental health workers, and a variety of other professionals who maintain programs for approximately 100 children in care 24 hours per day. We also support a fully licensed school for grades 1 through 12 pursuing their education. In these times of uncertainty, we have seen the best of our community emerge from our staff's dedication to organizations and individuals who contribute to our program. During this pandemic, we continue to see just how fortunate we are to have such passionate staff and caring supporters like Colonial Park. You can help Huffman's children withstand these unprecedented times with a donation payable to Colonial Park UCC, with Huffman Homes noted on the memo line. We thank Colonial Park for your many contributions of money and other gifts over the years. God bless each of us and our church. Thank you.
God sees all things. God sees our comings and our goings, our strengths and our weaknesses, our needs and our desires. God sees in us the potential we do not yet see in ourselves. I invite you to share your offerings and gifts out of the abundance that is God's vision for us. Please remember that while a church building may be closed, our resources are still used and bills need to be paid. Your faithful contributions support the ministry and outreach of this congregation and the wider church. Your financial support may be offered by check and mailed to CPUCC at 5000 Devonshire Road, Harrisburg, 17109. Online at cpucc.org, or via electronic funds transfer by contacting your bank or Kathy Neely.
Everybody, everybody needs
Everybody knew someone. Everybody is a friend of a friend who knew a friend of a friend who's got a friend who loved a friend. Everybody feels something. Everybody knew someone.
Friends, let us pray. Our Creator, great weaver, what was once formless and void has been transformed into a spacious place. We give in all shapes and forms for the sake of your creation and all who dwell in it. O God, small and humble in comparison, we give to you that you might mold our world anew. Amen.
Thank you.
My friends, as our service comes to a close, our worship, our work only begins. The grace of God deeper than our imagination, the strength of Christ stronger than our need, and the communion of the Holy Spirit richer than our togetherness, guide and sustain us today and in all our tomorrows. And may you go from your place, in whatever place that is, may you go from this place, wherever you are now, creating a new community, weaving something new out of what has been unraveled in your life, dreaming once again, but most of all, praying, turning to God again and again and again. Because even though it hasn't looked like our dream for the future, I have no doubt that God continues to say, oh, I know the plans I have for you. Plans for a future of hope. Go with God. Go in peace. And serve the Lord gladly. Amen.